Wake up and smell the barbecue. But first, sit back, relax, and enjoy Andy's grand tour of Andy Nelson's Southern Pit Barbecue.
There tonight, Linda?
You got a whole hog.
I go out walking after midnight, out in the moonlight, just like we used to do. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you. I walk for miles along the highway. Well, that's just my way of saying I love you. I'm always walking after midnight, searching for you. I stop to see a weeping willow crying on his pillow. Maybe he's crying for me. And as the skies turn gloomy, night winds whisper to me, I'm lonesome.
The story of barbecue is the story of America. And was there at the beginning of our nation's birth. The father of our country noted in his diary that he went up to Alexandria to a barbecue, which George said lasted 3 days. Our 16th president, Honest Abe, wasn't known as a big eater, but his parents had a big barbecue for their wedding celebration. Why, even Scarlett O'Hara met Rhett Butler at a barbecue in Gone with the Wind. Pitmaster started cooking the night before in big underground pits. When Scarlett arrived in the morning, she saw a haze of smoke hanging lazily in the top of tall trees and smelled the mingled savory odors of burning hickory logs and roasting pork and mutton. Barbecue is not just food, though. It's a national pastime older than baseball. It's about celebrating a real meal with friends and family by smoking meat low and slow, and most often all night long. Barbecue has a certain mystique about it. Each pitmaster prides himself on his unique touch or top secret ingredient. And without question, barbecue is the most fussed over and feuded over food in the U.S. of A. There's one thing all cooks can agree on, and that's quality. Whether it's Kansas City or Memphis ribs, Texas